The decision by a state commission to include Nat Turner on a slave memorial downtown is sure to get some people fired up. But it makes for an interesting parallel with the city's Lee Monument. Turner did bad things in the name of a noble cause, while Lee acted honorably in defense of a bad one. Today, Fredericksburg is holding a public hearing to get input on what to do with the city's slave auction block. Yes, you read that correctly. A stone auction block still stands at the downtown intersection of Williams and Charles. The NAACP says the block should be removed. It certainly should, and be placed in the Fredericksburg Area Museum, where nobody can stand on it for thoughtless picture-taking. If it isn't, then it should be fenced off, with appropriate historical markers added to explain what crimes against humanity occurred there. Remember Valerie Plame? The former CIA employee became something of a heroine among many Democrats, who saw her unmasking as further proof of the Bush administration's perfidy and the Iraq War's illegitimacy. Her autobiography was even turned into a movie. This week, Plame tweeted a link to an article from an obscure internet publication, uns.com, titled, America's Jews Are Driving America's Wars. After initially defending it as very provocative, but thoughtful, she apologized and claimed she didn't realize how blatantly anti-Semitic it was. That claim would hold up better if she had not also tweeted a link to a 2014 article from Uns titled, Why I Still Dislike Israel. Well put, she added. In a third tweet, in 2015, Plame linked to yet another Uns article, The Dancing Israelis, which suggests, regarding the 9/11's terrorist attacks, that there were Israeli fingerprints all over the place, and that Israel let it happen to bind Washington more closely to it. Pope Francis has admitted that the Catholic Church was a bit late in recognizing the harm done by pedophile priests. In related news, Roman General Lucius Cornelius Sulla has warned the people of Pompeii to keep an eye out for any volcanic activity from Mount Vesuvius. Speaking of being late, the state's auditor of public accounts, Martha Mavrids, is still waiting for documents from Richmond that were due in March and last November. Advice to Mavrids: don't sit on a hot stove while you wait.